SMU classrooms are now equipped with various technology to support both in-person and remote students. This video provides a brief introduction to the new devices, as well as other resources that faculty may find helpful in preparing for their courses. First is the audio equipment. Technology is now in each room to provide optimal audio from the instructor to remote participants. Depending on your assigned space, you'll find one of the following: a webcam with a built-in microphone, a lavalier or podium microphone, or microphones mounted in the ceiling. Except for the lavalier microphone, the other audio sources do not require any setup or configuration by you. As long as you are using the built-in equipment, including the podium computer if available, the audio should be captured. If you are in a room with the lavalier microphone, you will need to turn on the transmitter and clip the microphone to your shirt. Remember to turn off and return the microphone to the charging base when you are done, so it can be used by the next instructor. Now let's go over our new video options. In each room, you will find either a simple webcam or a camera mounted on a wall or ceiling to provide the video source for your meeting. The webcam will either be mounted on the podium or on a microphone stand. If it is on a microphone stand, you can move the camera to where it works best for your course. For example, you may need to focus it on the whiteboard, on yourself during a lecture, or on your audience during discussions. We have provided a long extension cable in order to give you the most flexibility. Many rooms feature a mounted pan, tilt, zoom, or PTZ camera. If the room has a touch panel, you will find three presets on the touch panel to control the composition of your video. These include a full wide-angle shot of the front of the classroom, or a zoomed-in shot of either the right or left side of the room. In many cases, this zoomed angle will display content from the whiteboard for your remote participants. In smaller seminar rooms, you may find a video conferencing device called the OWL. This provides audio as well as a 360-degree video feed. This is designed for small group discussions or rooms with a conference table layout. Whiteboards are often a critical part of instruction. Many rooms feature new technology which allows a remote participant to view and even collaborate on a shared whiteboard from afar. Several classrooms in Cox and Lyle have an interactive monitor on the podium. These allow an instructor to write using a stylus on the monitor. This provides annotation as well as a whiteboard-type surface without moving away from the podium. Other classrooms are equipped with an Epson interactive projector. These require the use of a digital pen in order for content to be captured electronically. By creating a shared whiteboard session, remote participants are able to join that session via a web browser and view the content on the board. The instructor can even start new pages of content while retaining the old content. The various screens can then be shared as PDF files after the class is complete. Around 50 classrooms on campus now have a device called Captivo. This is a camera that is mounted on top of a whiteboard. Remote participants can join via a web browser to view the content on the board. The instructor can use regular dry erase markers and write and erase normally. The camera captures only the writing and shares that via the browser. Similar to the Epson projector, it will retain slides of all whiteboard content during the shared session, which can then be emailed and saved. Document cameras are also installed in many rooms, which will provide instructors with the ability to write content and transmit it via Zoom. In this case, the instructor would write on a piece of paper on the desk, with the document camera aimed at the paper. On the podium computer, the faculty would view the document camera video using specialized software for the device. Simply sharing the desktop of the podium computer in Zoom would allow remote participants to view the content easily within their Zoom window. Document cameras can also be used to provide video of an experiment or tangible items in the classroom. In fact, we have installed a few document cameras that are highly flexible, allowing for various angles and can be easily manipulated as needed. Finally, many instructors find the iPad whiteboard to be extremely useful. These are not installed in classrooms, but are certainly another option for content sharing. Since each room offers a mixture of the technology we just introduced, you may be wondering what devices will be available to you in your classroom this fall. Once you have been assigned a room, take a look at smu.edu/classroomit. This page offers quick access to the technology available in each space. Please note, there are 250 rooms receiving new technology this summer, so the content will be updated over the next several weeks. As the fall semester approaches, the Academic Technology Service Directors will be sharing a wealth of information and training opportunities. In-person as well as remote training opportunities will be available to help you acclimate to the new SMUFlex classroom environment. And remember, we are here for you. If you need assistance or have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us. Thanks for watching.